Calvin Blitman has asked how to paint the uniforms of the Ventrillian Nobles. So in today's video, we're going to show you how to do that. But the first thing you need to do is undercut the model. And as you can see here, I've used Corax White Spray, which is a good starting point for this colour scheme. So after that, we'll start painting all the details. So first of all, with the tunic, we'll pick that out with Screamer Pink. Then we'll paint the armour, the boots and the belts using a Baden Black. Then we'll make a shade to go all over the whole model, and we'll mix this with Lamy Medium and Norn Oil. After that, we'll pick out the trousers again and the gloves using Orthwin Grey. Then we'll highlight the tunic using Pink Horror. Then as a final detail to the armour, we'll just do a bit of filigree around it using Retributor Armour, and then finish that off with Reichlin Fleshade Gloss. So starting with the tunic, we're going to use Screamer Pink. So I'm just going to use a medium layer brush here to apply some of that to the palette. I will thin this down a bit as well because it will give a nice even coverage. We'll have to do a couple of coats. Because it's thinned down, it will go into those recesses a lot easier as well. So let's start applying that. So just take your time with this. And if you do splodge onto the other areas, we can always coat back over that. With the tunic finished, we're now going to start painting the armour. And for this, we'll be using a Baden Black. We'll apply this in multiple coats. Also, don't forget to do the boots. And of course, the belt as well. Which is just around here. I recommend for this stage, you want to use a medium layer brush. With all those black details now done, we're going to apply a shade of Norn Oil. And this has been thinned down with Lamy Medium. And I've used 4 parts Lamy Medium to 1 part Norn Oil. You want to apply this over the whole model, and I'd use a medium shade brush for this. After giving that shade about half an hour to dry, we're now going to start highlighting with Orthwin Grey, and this is just on all the white details, so the trousers, the gloves. If I just flip them over, you've got the webbing as well, like his knives and ammo pouches. For this, I recommend using a small layer brush. With the white details done, we're now going to highlight the tunic. And for this, we'll be using Pink Horror. And I'll use a small layer brush. When highlighting, just focus on the tops of the creases as if there's a light source coming from above. With the tunic now highlighted, we're going to start doing the filigree on the black armour. For this, you want a small layer brush. And if we just get the shoulder pad, you just want to run it around all the edges as if you're doing a highlight, but actually it's just going to be one flat colour. I'm just going to run it around. Give it a nice baroque look. We'll do this on all the armour panels, as well as his helmet and the Imperial Eagle scattered across him. With the gold applied, we're now going to start applying Reichlin Fleshade Gloss over the entire armour. And we're doing this for two reasons. One, to shade the gold, but also to give a nice, cool, lacquered, glossy effect on the black as well. And with that, the Ventrillian Noble's uniform is done, with just a few details left to do before it goes off into the galaxy to do glorious combat. So I hope you found that useful, Calvin. Keep sending those requests in. We'll see you again soon. Bye-bye.